"But where did you get the key to unlock this door?" asked the clockwork voice.
"I found it on the shore, where it was probably washed up by the waves," she answered. "And now, sir, if you don't mind, I'll wind up your action."
"That will please me very much," said the machine.
So she wound up number three, and at once the copper man, in a somewhat stiff and jerky fashion, walked out of the rocky cavern, took off his copper hat, and bowed politely, and then kneeled before Dorothy. Said he,
"From this time forth, I am your obedient servant. Whatever you command, that I will do willingly, if you keep me wound up."
"What is your name?" she asked.
"Tick-tock," he replied. "My former master gave me that name because my clockwork always ticks when it is wound up."
"I can hear it now," said the yellow hen. "So can I," said Dorothy. And then she added, with some anxiety, "You don't strike, do you?"
"No," answered Tick-Tock. "And there is no alarm connected with my machinery. I can tell the time, though, by speaking, and as I never sleep, I can waken you at any hour you wish to get up in the morning."
"That's nice," said the little girl, "only I never wish to get up in the morning."
"You can sleep until I lay my egg," said the yellow hen. "Then when I cackle, Tick-Tock will know it is time to waken you."
"Do you lay your egg very early?" asked Dorothy.
"About 8 o'clock," said Billina, "and everyone ought to be up by that time, I'm sure."